presentations, activity and poetic discourse, all imbued with the ethos of various streams of education.
We invoke this program with a message coated with the essence of tribal music and dance.
Wonderful performance.
Yes, even I enjoyed every bit of it.
You have recently been to Jim Corbett. How was your trip?
It was amazing, Bhavik. I got to know so much about forests. Forests for us have held an allure as places of spirituality and striking imagery. They have inspired human tradition and folklore, appearing a symbol of knowledge, fertility and life. However, the value of forest extends far beyond the cultural and the aesthetic.
Absolutely, Pranav. They bridge many domains that are crucial to environmental health and human well-being. In fact, Pranav, let's hear what forests have to say about it.
I am the Amazon forest. We protect you from natural disasters and keep you safe by defending against natural hazards. Trees and other plants help prevent landslides by holding the soil in place and lessening the force of rain on the ground. Similarly, we stabilize shorelines and reduce the power of waves.
I am the fruit forest. We help to generate rainfall. Trees absorb water from their roots, which is later released as water vapor from their leaves. This water vapor accumulates into the clouds until it is again fallen as rain, snow, or hail. So,
I am the giant kelp forest. We produce life-saving medicines. We are often referred to as nature's medicine cabinet. We are the source of many ingredients that are used to create drugs to treat malaria, cancer, and other diseases. In fact, more than a quarter of modern medicines are derived from the tropical forest.
I am the alpine forest. We provide essential resources that are used in your daily lives. Many common household items such as furniture and books derive from the products that we provide. Just look around your house. How many things are made up of wood or other forest products? What about your floors, doors or slidings? Timber is the primary resource used to build homes in many parts of the world. Not to mention, many families rely on wood fuel to heat their homes.
I am the Samantha Forest. We provide food security and nutrition for many rural communities. We are their grocery stores. We are an excellent place to forage for wild fruits such as berries, mushrooms, leaves, tubers, and nuts.
I am Sundarbans Forest. We are a heaven of biodiversity. We are so much more than a bunch of trees, from different species singing on the treetops to ants marching along the forest floor. These complex ecosystems are full of life. In fact, it is estimated that forests are home to 80% of world's land-based plant and animal species.
Hills of tropical pine forest. We provide jobs millions of people worldwide. We sustain rulers' livelihood. This includes millions of people who are dependent on us for their survival.
I am the Black Forest. We fight climate change and clean the air. Where natural cover sinks, how we interact with them can either slow down the climate crisis. As trees and other plants grow, they absorb carbon dioxide and store in their trunks, roots, branches and soil.
I am the Atlantic Forest. We are the playground for recreation. Beyond the necessities, forests are also a source of fun, excitement and inspiration. Each year about 8 billion visitors explore the world's national parks and other protected areas, many of which are forested. From hiking to the climbing to mountain biking, we are a destination for epic adventures.
That's great! We have long appreciated forests as sources of food, fuel, materials and land. But advances in our scientific understanding have revealed the crucial, less visible services they also offer. But Bhavik, all these have further incited my quest to explore more about forests. For example, their location, sustainable forest parameters, rainfall, etc.
Most welcome, Pranav. Maybe our friends will be able to satisfy our appetite to know more about forests.
Thank you, Bhavik. I present you awesome geographical aspects of the tropical deciduous forests. It is found in the northeast of the peninsular plateaus covering Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh and Odisha. It receives an annual rainfall from 100 cm to 200 cm along with thunderstorms. And its average temperature is 30 degrees Celsius year-round. The trees of this forest shed their leaves during the dry seasons. And it consists of trees like sal, teak, shisham, peepal.
Thank you, Devrakshi. I also take this opportunity to present some facts about the thorny forests. It is found in Haryana, Rajasthan, Punjab, and some western parts of Gujarat. Here, rainfall is scanty and is less than 50 cm. Humidity is less than 50%. The mean temperature here is from 25 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius. Usually, this kind of forest is small in size and is scattered over a large area.
It consists of trees like kikar, babool and date palms.
Thank you, Vedika. I would like to add some facts about the mountain forest. This forest is found in different altitudes of the Himalayan mountains in states like Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, West Bengal, and Sikkim in India. The annual rainfall here is about 150 cm to 300 cm. The average summer and winter temperature is about 30 and 18 degrees Celsius respectively. The climate here is too cold with below freezing temperatures at elevations above 4,880 meters, and the area is permanently covered with snow and ice. Trees like oak, chestnut and pine are available in plenty in this forest. Thank you.
I would like to share some important information about the mangrove forest. It is found in lowland delta regions along the eastern coast of India, where tidal vegetation grows in swamps and marshes of salt and fresh waters. It gets 150 cm of annual rainfall. The climate in Sundarban ranges from 20 degrees Celsius to 34 degrees Celsius and consists of Sundari. That is why the tidal forests of Ganga Delta have been named as Sundarban.
Thank you, Lakshmi. I'd like to share some important information about the tropical rainforest. It is found in Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Western Ghat and the wet northeastern hilly part. It enjoys heavy rainfall over 200 cm per annum. And it has a monthly mean temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. This forest has mahogany, rosewood, ebony and bamboo and remains green throughout the year.
Pranav, thank you very much. Now I would like to go a little ahead of tropical evergreen forest and share some facts about dry evergreen forest. This forest is found in Shivalik Hills and the foothills of the Himalayas, up to the height of 1000 meters in the north, also along the Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka coast in the south. Its temperature is high all year round, with average temperature above 24 degrees Celsius. Along the coast of Tamil Nadu, there are areas which receive annual rainfall about 100 centimeters. Some of the common trees are the pomegranate, olive, oleander. Thank you.
Thanks to you and your friends, I was really oblivious to so many things. And your friends have helped me, indeed, to come closer to facts.
No need to thanks, Pranav. I myself have learned so much. In fact, I have something else to offer too.
What else? I am very excited to be a part of it.
Do you know some interesting facts about age of a tree?
Not really, but I would love to know about it.
Okay, let's have a look at it.
Friends, you know your birthday is very near. I'm planning a party for everyone.
Oh wow, that's great. You must keep your party in some open space so we can enjoy more and natural beauty.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
You know, we should have a picnic every week. It's fun.
Every week? Then when will we study? Anyways, let's under that big tree.
It looks like a really old tree. I wonder how old it is.
How will we tell a tree's age? I don't think he celebrates his birthday. Haha, it's not possible. What do you say, Anand?
I don't think so. Do you know how old you are?
Of course. I'm going to complete 11 years on my birthday.
If you know your age, then sure, there's a way to find how old this tree is. Well, I don't think so. The tree will tell you its age. Here comes Jenny and Akshay. Let's ask them.
Jenny, that tree looks very old. Everyone was wondering, is there any way we can find out how old the tree is?
Yes. We can tell the age of a tree by counting its rings.
Rings? What do you mean, Jenny?
If you slice a tree's trunk, you can clearly see its rings like concentric circles.
Really? circles with a common center and a different radii.
Yes, each ring is equal to 1 year of the tree's life, so we can easily tell how old the tree is. But unfortunately, to see the rings, we need to cut down the tree.
It's such a beautiful tree that I don't think we should cut it down. Rather, we should plant more trees. Here comes Dishu and Manasvi. Let's ask another way from them. Maybe they can tell us.
Hi friends, it can be very difficult to calculate the age of a tree if you don't know when it was planted. However, it is possible to estimate the age of a tree through an approximation technique, which is based on the circumference of its trunk. This method was first proposed by the International Society of Arboriculture, ISA.
Wrap the tape measure around the tree at about 4.5 feet above the ground. This measurement is the tree circumference. Write down this measurement.
It's time for a little bit of maths. Use the circumference to find the diameter of the tree. The formula for finding diameter is diameter is equal to circumference divided by pi, which is 3.14.
Now we can find the radius by dividing the diameter by 2.
Now we need to divide radius by average width of one ring. For a tree, average growth ring width is about 0.2 inches. So if the radius is 25 inches, we divide 25 by 0.2, which is equal to 125 years.
Wow, it's so informative. Also, we see that a little bit of math makes our daily life problems easier. Surely, math is everywhere.
Wonderful!
Pranav, you just heard what others have to say about trees. But don't you think given an opportunity, even trees would like to speak for themselves? Probably they'll yell out their frustration of not being allowed to sustain by human beings. Let us try and experience the same.
जंगल जंगल बात चली है पता चला है हर पेड़ों पर फूल खिले हैं जंगल जंगल बात चली है पता चला है हर पेड़ों पर फूल खिले हैं
डालियों को काट लेती हूँ जलाने में काम आएंगी और इसके फल कितने ताजा हैं इन्हें मैं बेचकर खूब सारे पैसे कमाऊंगी
मेरी टहनियों पर चिड़ियों के बहुत सारे घोंसले हैं
अरे इतने घने पेड़ है सरकार ने हाईवे रोड बनाने का नक्शा पास कर दिया है हम इन पेड़ों को काटना होगा
हमें मत काटो हम तुम्हें शुद्ध हवा देते
आह कितना घना पेड़ है पर मुझे इन पेड़ों के कारण गाड़ियों की पार्किंग की जगह नहीं मिल रही है इन्हें मैं काट देती हूँ
नहीं नहीं हमें मत काटो हम तुम्हारे घर को शीतल रखते हैं
वाह इतना घना जंगल सरकार का आदेश है कि इन जंगलों को काट कर बड़ी इमारतें बनानी है मैं इन जंगलों को काट डालू
नहीं नहीं हमें मत काटो अगर तुम हमें काटोगे तो पूरे पर्यावरण का संतुलन ही बिगड़ जाए
वाह कितना घना पेड़ है पर इस पेड़ की वजह से घर के अंदर मिट्टी कीड़े तथा दीमक की समस्या आने लगी है इसे काट देता
नहीं नहीं हमें मत काटो हम तुम्हें शीतल हवा देते हैं मिट्टी को बांध कर रखते हैं बारिश करने में भी सहायक हैं वे पर्यावरण का संतुलन भी बनाकर रखते हैं
ये मानव तुमने अपने जरूरतों के लिए सारे के सारे जंगल काट डाले जहाँ
इस धरती पर जंगल ही जंगल थे, आज उस धरती पर बस कंक्रीट और सीमेंट की इमारतें ही इमारतें हैं। तुमने सारे जंगल ही जंगल साफ कर डाले।
जंगल जंगल बात चली है पता चला है, हर पेड़ों को काट रखा है काट रखा है, हर पेड़ों को काट रखा है काट रखा है।
तो हम लोग हमारे लिए पेड़ों की अहमियत तो जानते ही हैं, साथ सरकार भी पेड़ बचाकर कई मुहिम चलाती रहती है, लेकिन जब तक आम नागरिक मतलब हम लोग पेड़ों को काटने से नहीं बचाएंगे या पेड़ बचने के प्रति सजग नहीं होंगे, पेड़ बचाने की बात बात ही रहेगी। अतः अंत में मैं आपसे यही कहना चाहता हूँ, पेड़ों के बिना मेरे यार जीवन में होगा अंधकार, वृक्षों की रख करोगे रक्षा तभी तो होगा जीवन अच्छा।
इट्स सो ग्रेट टू हियर द एग्री ऑफ ट्रीज फ्रॉम देम ओनली, दे मस्ट डू समथिंग।
That's not all, Pranav. There is another aspect of the same story. Forest not only comprises of trees, but also supports animals. Let us understand this aspect wrapped in melody.
Abhyaranyam, abhyaranyam, abhyaranye nasi bhayam. Abhyaranyam, abhyaranyam, abhyaranye nasi bhayam. अभयारण्ये के संति, अर्थात आइए हम सब वन्य जीवों के स्थान पर चलते हैं, वहाँ हमें कोई भी भय नहीं है। वन्य जीवों में कौन कौन है?
सिंह व्याघ्र गज च, सिंह गर्जति व्याघ्र गर्जति नर्दति गज उच्चैष्ट, नर्दति गज उच्चैष्ट, अर्थात वहाँ पर शेर बाघ और हाथी हैं। शेर दहाड़ रहा है, बाघ दहाड़ रहा है और हाथी चिंघाड़ रहा है।
वृकः शृगालः शल्यः च, वृकः धावति शृगालः च, धावति शल्यः वेगेन, धावति शल्यः वेगेन, अर्थात वहाँ भेड़िया शृगाल और लोमड़ी है, भेड़िया दौड़ता है, लोमड़ी भी दौड़ती है और गीदड़ भी तेजी से दौड़ता है।
कलियादह वन महिषः कीरिः, कलियादह रे निद्रां कुरुते, वन महिषः अपि निद्रां कुरुते, कीरिः अटति सर्वत्र, कीरिः अटति सर्वत्र, अर्थात वहाँ दरियाई घोड़ा वन महिषी और किरी है। दरियाई घोड़ा सो रहा है, वन महिषी भी सो रही है और किरी सब जगह घूम रहा है।
खड़गी चित्रोषः भल्लूकः, खड्गम मृगः तूष्णिम् दृश्यति, चित्रोषः अपि तूष्णिम् दृश्यति, भल्लूकः च उत्लवते, भल्लूकः च उत्लवते, भल्लूकः च उत्लवते, अर्थात खड़गी मृगः जिराफ और भालू हैं। खड़गी मृगः चुपचाप बैठा है, जिराफ भी चुपचाप बैठा है, भालू कूद रहा है।
Amazing! Forests are the areas where most of the species of flora and fauna are found. It is the lungs of our planet that take up carbon dioxide released by animals and give oxygen to the environment.
That is so true, Pranav. Not only flora and fauna, but forests also restore soil binding. But do you know, we ourselves are responsible for the depletion of such sources of life.
Why do you say so?
Let my friends explain this to you.
Waves, winds, water and glaciers shape and reshape Earth's surface by gradually wearing away rocks and soil. Through these processes, the material that makes up Earth's crust is moved from one place to another. When it rains, water that is not used by plants nor dried up by the sun slowly flows through the topsoil downhill into nearby water basins like rivers, streams, lakes, etc. When the flow of the water is slow, land changes and erosion occur very slowly over time. If the flow of the water in the topsoil is rapid, then changes to the landscape may occur rapidly as well. Another example of this rapid movement of topsoil is a landslide.
Soil is rich in nutrients, detritus, that is dead organic matter such as wood chips and leaves, and sometimes may even contain harmful pesticides. All of these things contained in soil can be carried by land runoff and eventually pollute our waterways that we rely on drinking water. In areas where the land is poorly managed, too much soil erosion can occur, which leads to the poor water quality.
Today's activity, we will explore how water runoff affects the transport of topsoil and water qualities under different land conditions.
Take 3 empty plastic bottles, fill 1 bottle with loose soil, second with a thin layer of soil and a top layer of detritus, and third with a thin layer of soil and a top layer of grass with roots. Pour water very slowly from a pitcher into each bottle and watch as the water passes through the soil and flows into the water reservoir.
Water in the first reservoir is very dirty. Loose soil such as soil found in deforested areas can be moved much more easy by running water.
As we can see, water in the second reservoir is not so clean. Detritus can protect soil from increased erosion by covering and protecting the layers of soil beneath it. When dead leaves on top of the ground soften the fall of raindrops and thus prevent the loosening of soil and the soil getting carried away.
Water in the third reservoir is very clean. Erosion occurs more slowly when soil contains both living plants and detritus. This is because plants open water as it flows over the land, allowing much of the rain to soak into the ground. The branches and leaves of the plants also soften the raindrops so that they do not hit the ground too hard and break apart the soil. The roots of the plants also hold soil together and make it harder to erode.
Human activities such as cutting down trees, removing vegetation, for example mining, are the activities that may increase erosion. As you saw in the experiment with the bottle, when we remove too many plants, there can be negative side effects such as reduced water quality. When the water flowed into the water reservoir, we noticed a difference in the color of the water coming out of the bottles. The bottle that had plants had produced the clearest water in the plastic cup because the roots of the plants protected the soil below from the water falling from above, and also the upper layer of the soil is held together by the roots of the plant.
Erosion is a serious problem for protective agriculture land and for water quality concerns. The most effective way to control erosion is to maintain a permanent surface cover over the soil surface, such as pasture or meadow. Therefore, areas that are highly susceptible to water or wind erosion need to be considered for soil conservation programs.
Did you see how important it is to conserve forests?
Yes, it is necessary without a doubt. And we all should contribute our bit in doing that. I take this opportunity to present a poem to be recited by my friend, sharing the same opinion.
Today, I, Kashvi, and my friends, Akshati and Deepti, are going to recite the poem in front of you titled, I Shall Protect the Forests by Loreen Hetrick.
Trees are like gift to the nature. They are very important to us. They fulfill all our needs. We are dependent on trees for every small need of us.
The scene is depicted by the poet in the form of a poem, which shows affection towards trees and their importance in our day-to-day life. How trees help us in every possible way. Here we go with the poem.
Have you ever really looked at trees and seen their perfect beauty? If you have, you know that their protection is a stem and sacred duty, protection of their spreading grandeur through many summers grown, safeguarding of those temples green where the song of birds is known.
Then remember that the forest fire is an enemy to fight. It is a tree assassin to be, watched both day and night. A campfire left unguarded or a match tossed carelessly may bring destruction with great loss and deepest tragedy.
When next you see the white crown branches of a graceful pine,
think to yourself, a sacred service is part and parcel of mine. I resolve to protect all the trees forever and guard their heaven-sent beauty. To save the trees of a land shall ever be my duty.
I had such a wonderful day today. A trip to Jim Corbett and a retail slave shear have added so much to my knowledge about the forest.
Indeed, it was a wonderful day, Pranav. Goodbye.
Goodbye.